It's 9:15. Thanks so much for being with us on Live at 9. Reducing crime in the Mid-South, certainly no easy task for law enforcement, but there is one program that aims to help deter a number of high-risk offenders and get them on a better path to success.
Yeah, here to explain Operation and how it works is Shelby County Mayor Lee Harris and Bill Gibbons from the Memphis Shelby County Crime Commission. Gentlemen, glad to have
good
you
to
both
have
here.
You.
Great.
So how exactly does it work? This sounds like a very interesting program.
Right, so I think we have an event coming up because there's a lot of resources across our county that are devoted to helping people who have a criminal history. We've got tens of thousands of people that have a criminal history, and the fear is that if we don't give them the opportunity to get back into the economy, back into the workforce, that they'll commit a second crime.
Right.
That second crime, we know we have high recidivism rates, and that second crime has a good chance of being worse than that first crime that created that criminal history in the first place. And so if we're going to prevent future crimes, if we're going to lower our recidivism rates, which comes at great cost, we've got to do a better job of making sure that those with criminal history get back into the workforce. So we've got a lot of kind of tools that are coming online to help in that regard.
That was one of the first things you did, in fact, when you took office. You expanded the Office of Reentry. This was a priority. Did you get a whole lot of pushback on that just from members of the community who we sometimes seem in America to have more of a we want to punish you rather than redeem you attitude, but also it's a for-profit industry that you're pushing up against. I mean, there's a lot of money in incarceration. Did you get pushback?
So there is a lot of money in incarceration, and I know that all too well, right? It costs over $100 million for us to run the Bailey Justice Center, which is just one facility.
Right.
So there's a lot of money, but the good news is everybody's on the same page in this community and in other places with respect to rehabilitative efforts, trying to make sure that those with criminal history get a chance to reintegrate community. And so that's with respect to, you know, party or rural, urban. Everybody wants to give people an opportunity to get a job, get back to work, and to take care of the family, and to get back on the right track. So I think that's, you know, the redemption and grace, I think that's something that, you know, I have felt from the start. So we've invested in the Office of Reentry, like you suggested.
Right.
We also have some programming at our Division of Corrections. So we also have some opportunity for people to learn hard skills like carpentry and so forth at the penal farm. And so we continue to, you know, laser focus on this because it affects many more parts of our community than you would ever suspect.
Right.
I'm talking tens of thousands, even over 100,000 folks with a criminal history that could stand to be helped in this regard.
So Bill Gibbons, obviously the entire community impacted one way or another by something like this, by criminals out there or former criminals. What are some of the variables, though, to pull it all together to make sure it works even better?
Well, I think the key is connecting the dots. We have a lot of job categories in Memphis where there's a labor shortage. For example, workers in the distribution industry, trades such as carpentry and masonry, machinists. We have employers looking for workers in those types of areas. At the same time, as the mayor pointed out, we have thousands of ex-offenders looking for jobs.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of those ex-offenders could meet those job needs. So we need to connect the dots between the employers and ex-offenders who can potentially be the employees.
So where is the disconnect, if there is one? Is it in training? Are we not giving enough training opportunities, or are employers reluctant for some reason? Where's the biggest disconnect that we need to address right now?
I think it's to some degree a lack of knowledge on the part of employers that we have these pools, these sources of ex-offenders who do have the skills, both the technical skills and the life skills. And what we hope to do at a June 11th forum is to connect those dots and to explain to employers exactly who they need to contact and how they can contact those entities in order to consider those ex-offenders as employees.
So Mayor Harris, what would be or what is the selling point for those who are still a bit reluctant to warm up to this program, who are really saying or might be saying, who really says these ex-offenders really want to make a change in their lives?
Right.
I think it's that we want our community to be successful, and the only way our community is going to be successful is for us to figure out an answer to the crime problem. The crime problem, to approach it, you have to have a lot of different kinds of approaches, and one is reentry. So it's not just about the arrest and prosecution, although those are very important for public safety. It is also about reentry, making sure that you have a pathway for people with a criminal history to get back into the workforce. So that's why the June 11th forum is so important, because we're going to bring to bear a lot of the assets around town so people can, you know, be aware of them. So, you know, we've got local assets, obviously state assets, you know, we've got the Crime Commission, the University of Memphis. All these folks are coming together to say, hey, we are on this path of creating opportunities for people with criminal history to get back into the workforce.
All right, very June 11th.
All right.
Thank you so much.
While we have you here very quickly, though, Mayor, Shelby County Schools budget, we just had the superintendent on. What's your take there? $10 million more, is that money in the budget? Can it be found?
There's 30 days left, so obviously this is a tough time crunch. We've been working with them for several months, and so in the last 30 days, $10 million request is a tough one in the last 30 days of this process, and obviously I can't do their budgeting, but obviously I wish that would have come earlier. The important thing, though, is that if there is additional money invested in Shelby County Schools, in my view, the first order of business has to be the cafeteria workers. There are 680 cafeteria workers, some of whom will make $11.50 an hour. They are living in poverty, and that is an issue that I believe we've got the right people now in place that we can address that issue. So I'm hopeful that when we talk about all the various programs and initiatives and bright ideas and, you know, all these types of things, that we really look at the folks that are living in poverty. We have too many people living in poverty, 680 cafeteria workers. It's time to get those folks out of poverty. I'm even told that 40 civil rights organizations and faith leaders and others will add their voice to this debate today. Wow. And say, we've got to get those cafeteria workers out of poverty. We've got to pay them a living wage, and we really need some leadership on the part of Shelby County government, which I'm a part, and the Shelby County school system.
You may have a hard sell, though, because it's not classroom, and you know the public.
Well, keep us posted for sure.
I think the public wants people out of poverty.
Okay.
All right. We'll see if we can sell it.
Bill Gibbons, gentlemen, thank you very much. We have the information on the screen about your event coming up. We do appreciate you being here.
Thanks.